How's it going, guys? My name is TopSecretR35 and welcome back to another episode of Forza Horizon 4. So update 22 just rolled around on Monday and we unlocked the first car, the first new car to the update, the 1994 Toyota Celica GT4 ST205. All I had to do was complete the season event. It's called What's the Word on the Street? And I can swear that this is a quote from The Fast and the Furious in the first movie where Leon, the guy that drives the R33, I'm pretty sure he says, "What's the word on the street?" before they go racing. Or Dom asks him, "What's the word on the street?" and he checks the police scanners. I don't know, maybe I'm crazy. Can somebody look into that? Thank you. So back to the car at hand, we have the Toyota Celica GT4. This was created to compete in the World Rally Championship. According to my buddy Wikipedia, this was the homologation special vehicle powered by the 3S GTE engine. I think it's obviously a turbo 2-liter four-cylinder as usual. And I'm almost certain that Forza did something with the sounds here, because I mean, listen to this. That sounds freaking cool. And this is completely standard. Wow. Take a look at the in-car view here. Oh yeah, it's cool. Let's try to take this corner here. We can hear the turbo build up a little bit. Listen. Oh yeah, that's cool. The plan for today's video, I am going to take this car and turn it into, well, my best ability, turn it into the WRC equivalent. And we're going to go tackle maybe a rally time trial, a rally time attack or some sort. See what we can do with it. So yeah, I'll meet you guys down at the tuning shop. So I was doing some more research and it turns out the ST205, what I have here in front of me, didn't actually compete for that long. It turns out that it had the intake restricted diameter regulation and it was too big. And the car was like stripped of all the points in that season in 1995 and thus ending the car's racing after just one season. So, well, I'm going to try to ignore that right now. So I'm seeing here the most important thing is that the car had 300 horsepower and obviously a huge amount of torque because it was a rally car. So yeah, let's get going. So I guess I'm going to start with the most obvious thing first. We're going to put on rally tires. So I'm looking at a picture of the ST205 GT4 and this is what I can find in terms of the wheels. I think these are actually meant for rally as well. So yeah, let's do it. So it looks like this car did have an improved track over the previous ST185. So we'll go ahead and do that. I did widen the tires. Let me see what size wheels if I can find that over here too. All right, so it already has 16-inch wheels on and this is what the actual car had too. So we'll leave that. Perfect. All right, we are on our way. And I'm gonna go ahead and say that this probably is not factually correct, but I'm gonna put on this body kit as anyway. I think it's gonna look cool with the livery and stuff like that. And then it looks like the real car actually has the stock wing that it currently has on right now, so I'm gonna leave that. And in terms of the rear bumper, wow, this looks aggressive. Got a little diffuser there and everything, huh? Okay. And then yeah, let's just complete the whole look here. Oh, so putting on these skirts actually changes the drag down to -1%. Ha, find that hard to believe, but okay. So I went ahead, I did everything in drivetrain, and now I'm gonna do everything over here as well. Obviously put on the rally springs, lift this thing in the air, and then everything to do with torsion, strength, safety, and weight reduction. Okay. So this thing is already looking nice. Like, I am liking this. This looks sick. It's almost like I don't even have to put on the paint job, but obviously I will. And even though the car just came out today, I promise that somebody has already made that iconic WRC looking job. All right, so I'm kind of cheating here. I'm going 36 horsepower above, but that puts us in A800, which will make a perfect competitor for whatever rally stage course time attack thing that we choose. So yes, this thing's looking good. And like I was expecting, the first one that we choose here, 1,552 downloads already. Wombi62, thank you, my man. I'm taking this for me, thanks. Well, what do we have here? Almost the full-blown rally car. This thing looks so freaking nice. I like to experience getting into the car and starting it up just like this. Okay, we just gotta find the damn place though. Here we go. Yep, here it is. All right, hold up. Shh. Here we go. Everybody settle down. Oh man, that is so cool! Oh my goodness, is my next car gonna be a Celica? Maybe. Okay, stop fanboying, let's go drive! So did we just build the most perfect Toyota Celica? Oh man, this is awesome. This is awesome. Well, we're off-road. It's time to give this thing a test. Okay, there's like a drift zone here, but I'm not gonna bother drifting. This is serious business. I wanna go as fast as I can through this thing. That's terrible. Come on, focus. Yeah, here we go. This is more serious. get a little bit of training in before we tackle on Time Attack. All right, there we go. Easy. All right, I'm going to try that one more time. But I'm going to go from the opposite direction here. I want to get it a bit more neat. Get my rallying skill up a bit here. I know I've been doing a lot of like the best rally car in the game, so on and so forth. But it's nice to have one that's like a bit underpowered and a bit more realistic, you know. I'm more into doing realistic builds nowadays compared to just jamming 1,200 horsepower into every single damn car possible, you know. Alright, here we go. Gotta keep it on the top of that rev range and get the car to slide a bit more. The more sliding I can do, the faster I can get through these corners. Use the momentum. Alright, so the reverse way. I think I definitely did better than the way coming in. Okay, let's take a right over here, see where it takes me. Flat on the power. There's big jump. Woohoo! A little bit of rally cross, take it to the street. Wow, I did two roads back to back. I think I have the feel for this car in A800. Let's see what I look like on the leaderboard. Probably not gonna be great, but you know, can only go up from that. Alright guys, I'm gonna try my utmost to focus here. I'm not gonna get a caution, so I'm not gonna make any accidents. And I'm not going to use rewind, obviously. So I'm gonna be extra on the brakes, but not too extra. And hopefully we can get a reasonable time over here. I know that the best in the world at 1 minute 52 is probably out of my reach here. I'm gonna need more power and less like other upgrades. But anyway, I'm just here to have a good time. I'm here for a good time, not for a fast time. Okay, so chill. So I guess while we're racing, why don't you guys leave a... Oh my goodness. Thought I'm gonna hit that wall, sorry. Why don't you guys leave a comment down below about what car you're most excited for in this update. I think there's 6 to choose from. There's 2 Celicas, and then a Mitsubishi Storion or something like that? I don't know. And then a Ford Racing Puma, and I can't think right now what the other 2 are. I think this car right here is probably my favorite already, the GT4 Celica. I see these things for sale on JapaneseClassics.com the whole time. I think they go for like $18,000, which, oh man, it's a lot of money, but it's pretty iconic car as well. Then again, people are charging like $70,000 for MK4 Supra, so I guess in the grand scheme of things, it's not that bad. Okay, so focusing pretty hard here, have not crashed yet. And I'm 70% done. I'm 12 seconds away from 1 minute 52 already, so you can say goodbye to that. easy. Okay, I know this part. I did a speed zone here the other day in my Ford, the Focus RS200 video that I made. So I won't crash there. And straight towards the line. Come on, let's go. Come on, go! I want to get a decent place in the global ranking on my first ever try. Alright, 2 minutes 14, holy crap, 6, what? Oof, wow, that's a long time off the other guy. Wow, my Elgato was recording for so long that my computer almost ran out of space. That's how long I had to scroll down here. But I'm number 815 out of 6,238 at 2 minutes 14, holy crap. Okay, I know I can do better, but you know, I was just having a good time. Well guys, I hope you enjoyed the video, the Celica GT4. I think this car is freaking awesome. What a beauty. Update 22 is great. I love the fact that they added all these rally, normal, JDM, and, you know, the Peugeot 205, I think. That's the other one. There we go. I remember now. And also, thank you guys for 600 subs. It's amazing. You know, this is exactly what I always thought of YouTube, like just having fun, playing games, talking about cars. It is freaking awesome. If you guys are new to the channel, first time you're watching one of my videos, why not subscribe? We do stuff like this all the damn time. And don't forget to hit that like button. I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace.